Hello students and welcome to the e-learning program initiated by Shri Gyan Manjri Vidyapeeth for the students of Standard 10 in which we are learning the subject of social science. Students, from the previous lecture we started with the chapter number 18, that is the fourth and the last chapter of the economics part of this syllabus. The syllabus for economics complete here is chapter number 15, 16, 17, which we have already completed. Now we come to chapter number 18, and name of the chapter is price rise and consumer awareness. That means there are two parts in this particular chapter. One deals with price rise, another deals with the consumer awareness. We started with the first section, that is price rise. Let us take a quick recap of what we have learned in the previous lecture. We started with price rise, and the first thing that we dealt with, what is price rise? Continuous and constant rise in the prices in different fields of the economy is, and that also at a very high rate, that is called price rise. Now, if the prices are rising in a stable manner, that is beneficial to the economy of the country. That means it is beneficial to the people. How? When the prices rise, profit increases. The producers, they also increase their profits. Higher growth in profit motivates the producers to invest more in the market, because now they have more money in the market, they can invest more. Suppose they make their products available to more and more dealers. Earlier they were not able to do so because their production was limited and they were not able to cater to a number of retailers. For example, one production shop, soap. Now, well, that soap production was limited, and so he was able to cater to only say 200 retail shops only, because whatever he produced got sold in those 200 shops, and per month whatever he produced, it was consumed, and he did not produce more, so he was not able to cater to more than 200 shops. Now he got ample amount of profit because the price rise was stable. Earlier his soap maybe was selling at 20 rupees, now he increased the price to 22, so he had more profit, and so he has accumulated enough profit to set up another factory or to increase his production, buy new machines and increase his production, take in new employees so that the production increases, and now his production has doubled. So now instead of 200 retailers or shopkeepers he was selling his soap to, now he can sell to 400 retailers. That means expand his business. He was able to do that because of the price rise. Then the increased production is also going to generate more employment, that we saw. Again, increase in sales and hence income, due to which producers and traders, they increase their wages of their employees also. Now he is earning more. More people are working under him. So time to time he has to increase their salary also. So now those employees also have more money in their hands, and they go to the market and buy things, right? So demand in the market goes up because now employees are having money in their hands. So higher wages increasing their purchasing capacity, that we saw. Now more and more people are going into the market to buy goods and services. So increase in their standard of living also happens when people spend more, purchasing more and more from the market. Economy starts growing. On the opposite, we saw that price rise also hinders the economy. When does that happen? When the price rise is invariable and we do not know why it is shooting up. So increases invariably, continuously and at a very high rate, then that means more and more money is pumping into the market because people have to pay more to get that same thing. Yes, earlier people paid 20 rupees to get that soap. Now they have to pay 25 rupees to get that soap. They are getting that same soap, but 5 rupees more from their pocket is entering the market. So same way, thousands of people, lakhs of people are buying so much goods and materials and services. Everywhere more and more money is coming into the market, but they are getting that same amount or sometimes even less. So same time, production has not increased, services, goods and services, that has not increased, and only the price has risen. So customer is paying more but waiting less. In such a situation there occurs high disturbance in the prices and also confusion remains in the market as to where to keep the prices, how to cope up with the income that we are having. So prices to set, income and expenditure, cost of production, everything rises because the price is rising. So people do not have clarity about these things and they have to change their decision again and again, again and again, and they need to economic activities get affected. In such a condition, price rise becomes hindrance in the development of the economy. Then we saw that price rise as beneficial as well as hindrance economic development that we have already seen. Now, this is the last point that we had seen. Two major factors responsible for price rise. One is lack of instantaneous increase in production and supply of commodities and services in the economy, that we saw with the help of SIM cards and onions, that all of a sudden there is a shortage of, say, SIM cards, or there is a shortage of, say, onions. People are demanding it, so they are ready to pay more, but the supply is not that much. So price keeps on going high invariably at a very high rate. That is factor number one. Continuous price rises seen due to sharp increase in total demand of the country as compared to the supply. Okay, you are not getting onions over here, but onions are produced somewhere else also. So what happens is people will bring onion from there to here, so the supply will increase a little bit, right? So the prices have to come down. But overall in the country, if the supply is not that much but the demand is quite high, then certainly there will be a price rise. So these are two factors that we saw till now. Next, we saw plan and non-plan expenditure, which we are going to study today. What is non-plan expenditure? And please remember, this is of the government. The government has two type of expenditures. One is planned expenditure, another one is non-planned expenditure. So we are going to learn about the non-plan expenditure first. The expenditure to be done for day-to-day routine activities of the government is called non-plan expenditure. It is on a day-to-day basis. Suppose the government takes a decision to build a dam or a multi-purpose project somewhere, it's going to take 10 years. Everything is kept in mind while planning out the building of that multi-purpose project. A planning is done. What will be the total cost of making that multi-purpose project? Right? In that time, what will be the price rise? Today we are getting the cement bag at, suppose, 85 rupees, or you can say 500 rupees per bag. After 8 years, there's going to be increase in the price of one bag of cement, right? So from, say, 500, it goes up to 600. So that is also accounted what will happen after 8 years. That is planned expenditure, because the complete expenditure of making the multi-purpose dam is not to be given today. It is to be given stepwise as the development takes place in the construction of the dam. That much money they have to keep on allotting every 6 months, every 1 year, every 2 years, that way. So that is planned expenditure. What is non-planned expenditure? That is day-to-day expenditure that is done. Examples are given: administrative expenses of the government. Now, what are administrative expenses of the government? You see, there are lots and lots of government offices. वहाँ पे बिजली खर्चा होती है, yes. Lights, fans, ACs, they are working over there. Government officials, उनको vehicles दिया है, तो vehicles में diesel, petrol लगता है, right? So, officials, they go on a tour, that is their official duty. So, that is part of their job and that is sanctioned, right? So, all that is day-to-day. Yes, आज जो है 200 रुपए का diesel लगा, कल diesel नहीं भी लगेगा, परसों भी नहीं जाएंगे, साहब बीमार हो गए, नहीं गए, तो गाड़ी नहीं जाएगी. राइट तो उतना कट हो गया. अब दो तीन दिन बीमार रहे तो साहब जो है एक ही दिन में 200 किलोमीटर घूम लिया. राइट सो दैट इज नॉट प्लान्ड. सो एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव एक्सपेंसेस ऑफ द गवर्नमेंट. सैलरीज ऑफ द गवर्नमेंट एम्प्लॉयज, that is also done on a date, because every month the salary has to be paid. So salary is counted on a day-to-day basis. That aaj aaye to aapki salary mein count hoga, kal aapne chutti li to utna deduct ho jayega. Right, so that way, day to day, and every 6 months, 1 year, the government have to pay them DA and HRA and all that. Yes, dearness allowances, house rent allowances. So that keeps on variation. That's on a variation basis, right? So every 6 months, it's not the same. So it is counted on a day to day basis. So employees ka jo salary hota hai, government employees ka, that is a non-planned expenditure. Different welfare schemes and fares. We just know, we have gone through the COVID scenario in the corona pandemic, right? Lots of people, they did not have food because curfew tha, you are not able to go out, right? The food has to reach you. At that time, the government did not care about how will they get back the money spent on the food. They just gave it for free. Was it planned? 1 year back, did the government plan next year corona aayega to hamara itna kharcha ho? No. So that is not accounted for. It's accounted, but then it was not planned, right? So different welfare schemes, right? Because of the pandemic, lots of schemes, new schemes have to, because lots of people became unemployed. They have to be given employment. They have to be given the food, right? So new schemes have to be launched, and that was not planned. That scheme came out of the necessity of the people, welfare to be given to the people, which was not planned. Yes, and we do not know how many people are going to be covered in that. Example, lots of insurance was given to poor people who died during the pandemic, though lots of people died from transiting from one place to another or going back to a home. So insurance was given to them, certain compensation was given to the family. All of that was not planned. So that is non-planned expenditure. Celebrations and various other public and private expenditure. Lots of celebrations keep on happening all around the country, even at state level, at national level. Lots of celebrations keep on happening. For example, Commonwealth game hota hai. Right, yeah, SAARC ki meeting hoti hai. So lots and lots of celebrations are there, meetings are there, some public expenditure is there, some private expenditure is also there. So in that way, all these expenditures come under the category of non-planned expenditure. Now, planned expenditure. What is planned expenditure? The expenditure that government thoroughly discusses in the budget and set estimate for it. It is for it in the planning commission under the 5-year plan is called planned expenditure. Let's learn that in one way. Budget. Let us not understand and go into details right about the budget of the country. Right, we are not going into that much, too much deep in the subject topic. Let us just take a small example of budget, the household budget. Each and every student, they live in a family earns money, and they have their monthly budget, their yearly budget. That father knows this thing, that I earn this much, right? So that is where the rupee comes in. एक रुपया का कॉइन है ये. What is this? एक रुपया का कॉइन. So that is 1 rupee, right? So father knows where the rupee comes from. Yes, and father knows where that rupee goes. This is budgeting. It's very simple. Let us just understand budget in a very concise, very precise, and quite a clear-cut meaning of budget. Whatever remains with you is budget. You are budgeting. Yes, father knows, suppose his salary is 20,000 rupees. He knows 20,000 rupees se ek rupiya bhi mere paas jyada nahi aata, because I am an employee, I am in the working class, and I am a salaried person. I get a salary of 20,000 rupees. I'm just giving an example, right? So that is the only income he is having. So he gets 20,000. Out of that, whole of the household expenses, जिसमें grocery भी आ गया, right? Electricity का bill आ गया, gas का bill आ गया, petrol का bill आ गया, whatever you say, education का, medicine का, सब का bill आ गया. What is the expenditure? 15,000. What remains with father per month? He is able to save 5,000. That is his budget. This is all essential requirements of the month. You cannot do away with that. He cannot compromise on the food that is given to the children. Money that is spent on food for the family, he cannot compromise. There will be old people in the family. There will be young children in the family. Medicine expenses for either any of the family member, he just cannot compromise. ये नहीं बोल सकता कि X-ray लेना है. Yes, अभी नहीं, अगले महीना. No, he cannot compromise. So these are the essentials we are working with. He cannot do away with that. What remains with him is 5,000 rupees per month. So at the end of 6 months, he will be having 30,000 rupees with him. Because this is constant, this is almost constant. If your demand doesn't go up, then this is constant, right? So this is the saving that he has done. He is able to do this because of planned expenditure. Yes, he is able to do this because you people are so good that you don't have any unnecessary demands, and he is able to save this much at the end of 6 months, right? So you are very good people, right? So this is just a small example to show us what expenditure, planned expenditure is, right? So now let us come to what the book has to say about planned expenditure, right? Planned expenditure, it is decided in the budget where the money comes from, where the money is going to go. Because where the money is going to come, that is the income of the government. Where does the money come from? That is the income of the government. And the government has to spend the money on the welfare of the people, for the betterment of the people, to give them more and more facilities and utilities, right? So that is their expenditure. So the expenditure that the government thoroughly discusses in the budget, ki is area mein aur itne char aise area hai jahan pe pani ka bahut problem hai, we have to construct a dam, we cannot do about that, and for that we have to keep this much money separate this year for starting the project. Then railway comes up, hamare itne bij purane ho gaye, इतने इंजन पुराने हो गए, हमको बदली करना है, इंजन नया लेना है, इतने ब्रिजेस बनाने, इतना ट्रैक और डेवलप करना है. मनी गोज ओवर देयर, दैट इज प्लान्ड. यस, हर एक स्टेट को अपने रोड्स डेवलप करने के लिए, रोड्स मेंटेन करने के लिए इतना पैसा देना है, दैट इज प्लान्ड. सो थरली डिस्कसेस इन द बजट एंड सेट्स एस्टिमेट इन द प्लानिंग कमीशन अंडर द 5-year प्लान. Yes, lots of 5-year plan. Ek 5-year plan complete ho gaya. For example, we learned about the 5-year plan, that is Green Revolution, in chapter number 10 regarding agriculture, right? So aise kahi sare 5-year plan chalte, ek ka end hota hai to dusre ka shuru hota hai. So 5-year plan, this much is the total expenditure that's going to happen in 5-year plan. Out of that, first year this much expenditure, so this amount is set apart. So that is planned expenditure, right? Example, expenditure to be done on building roads, bridges, generating electricity, raising irrigational facilities. Yes, itne dam banane, itne canals banane hai, itne roads banane, itne railway bridges banane hai. All of that is decided. The money is kept separate. दैट इज प्लान्ड एक्सपेंडिचर राइट, बाकी पूरा अनप्लान्ड होता है, दैट वी जस्ट सॉ. नाउ वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट अगेन फॉर यू, रीजंस फॉर प्राइस राइज राइट. नाउ इन चैप्टर नंबर 17 दैट इज पॉवर्टी एंड अनएम्प्लॉयमेंट ऑल्सो, when we learnt about poverty we should know why there is poverty, what are the reasons for poverty. If we are studying unemployment we should first study the reasons for unemployment. Same way we are in this chapter learning about price rise, then we should know what are the reasons for price rise. So this question becomes very very important for us, why is there a price rise. So first thing is increase in monetary supply by the government. हम पहले government से काम चलाते हैं right, फिर हम अपने पे आएंगे. So increase in monetary supply, monetary supply, monetary means related to money or the money itself. Government जानबूझ के country के अंदर पैसे बढ़ा देते हैं, पैसे की जो quantity होती है वो बढ़ा देती है राइट right? उससे क्या होता है, लोगों के हाथ में पैसा आता है. और आपको पता है लोगों के हाथ में पैसा आता है तो क्या होते हैं, उड़ाते. दैट इज द रीजन राइट. सो इंक्रीज इन मॉनेटरी सप्लाई बाय द गवर्नमेंट. नाउ हाउ डज दैट हैपन, वी हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड गवर्नमेंट इज नॉट फूलिश. मैन लुक बट इट्स नॉट फूलिश राइट. सो देर आर थ्री वेज इन विच गवर्नमेंट कैन इंक्रीज द सप्लाई ऑफ मनी इन द इकोनॉमी. गवर्नमेंट सप्लाई तभी बढ़ाती है जब नहीं होता है. अननेसेसरी वाई इज देयर अ रीजन. यस, यू थिंक पापा इज फूलिश. कभी घर पे आए और आपके हाथ में 5,000 रुपया रखा, जा बेटा उड़ा. दैट इज नेवर हैपन एंड दैट्स नॉट इवन गोइंग टू हैपन राइट. सो नो गवर्नमेंट इंक्लूडिंग गवर्नमेंट एट होम राइट इज फूलिश. सो there should be a reason why the government increases the total quantity of money in the country. It's not about Gujarat state or Maharashtra state or UP, that happens at central level right. So why is the government, that's the first question, why is the government increasing the monetary supply in the country. Take the recent example, everybody was at home, nobody was working for 3 to 4 months. तो क्या हुआ, किसी के पास पैसा नहीं है, किसी की फैक्ट्री नहीं चल रही है, किसी की ऑफिस नहीं चल रही है, चाय की दुकान तक नहीं चल रही है, पैसा कहां से आएगा. अंडरस्टैंड. सो गवर्नमेंट हैज टू पंप इन मनी. ओके, सो बाय फिलिंग डेफिसिट रिप्लेसमेंट. नाउ वी आर टॉकिंग यस, कोरोना क्राइसिस अभी आया, अर्लियर ऐसा कुछ नहीं था right, but still. So we are talking these whatever reasons are there, they are in normal conditions of any country right. So a first may a please remember and so your material also, and please do it that way so that you don't confuse the points. First, reasons for price rise, the first is increase of monetary supply by government. There are three ways, usme se a first one, by filling deficit replacement, that is generating new money, or it means increase in supply of money. Ab ye kaise hoga, simple term, very simple, we'll learn it at all the examples given will be from home so that we are able to understand better right. We just took the example of budget where the income of the father was 20,000 and the expenditure was 15,000. He was able to save 5,000 per month right. Now his income is still 20,000 but expenditure is 25,000. There is a deficit of minus 5,000. Opposite scenario, डेफिसिट, इसको क्या बोलेंगे हम, डेफिसिट माइनस नेगेटिव है, सो डेफिसिट इट इज डेफिशिएंट. व्हाट इज डेफिसिट, इट्स डेफिशिएंट. 5000 रुपीज का खड्डा पड़ गया, 20 आया 25 चला गया. एंड वी विल कम टू द स्टैंडर्ड वन दैट ही डिड नॉट हैव एनी सेविंग, राइट. सो 20,000 केम बट 25,000 वेंट अवे, हाउ, ये खड्डा कहां से भरा. यस, सो ही मस्ट हैव टेकन अ लोन, ही मस्ट हैव टेकन अ लोन फ्रॉम, या फादर हैज गॉट मेनी फ्रेंड्स, मेनी वेल विशर्स, लॉट्स ऑफ रिलेटिव्स, एनीवेयर. He took a small amount of 5,000 from someone because that month his income and expenditure got imbalanced. This is filling the deficit. Filling the deficit. क्योंकि पिताजी नोट नहीं छाप सकते, illegal है. Government के लिए legal है. So, government नोट मांगती है, आरबीआई छापती है, गवर्नमेंट को पैसा जितना चाहिए तो मिल जाता है, फिलिंग अप द डेफिसिट. अंडरस्टैंड दिस पॉइंट स्टूडेंट्स, बाय फिलिंग डेफिसिट रिप्लेसमेंट, दैट मींस जितना डेफिसिट है उतना पैसा आरबीआई से या कहीं से भी एडजस्ट करके ले लिया. सो खड्डा भर गया, जितना इनकम था और जितना डिमांड था उतना सप्लाई हो गया, मनी इज देयर इन द मार्केट, राइट. किसी को पता ही नहीं है क्या हुआ, right? But this is how it happens. Increase in the supply of money. Now, how does that happen? Please, again, I'll just... By filling deficit replacement, that is by generating new money. That 5,000 ka gap hai, negative mein. So, father needs that 5,000. So, he takes it from someone as a temporary loan, which he is going to fulfill next month. But right now he generated money anyhow. That 5,000 rupees was generated and that gap of income and expenditure leveled. So now his income is 20 plus 5,000 and expenditure is 25,000, which becomes equal. So we are going to learn in that way. Now good governance, what is the word used over here? Good governance leads to economic development. The government is working very hard for the betterment of the people, for the welfare of the people, and for that it has to expend money. Then only it will be called good governance. Right? So good governance leads to economic development. Due to economic development, amount of money increases in the economy and economy of the people increases. That we have learned in the starting. That when the economy is good, when is the economy is good? When everybody has more money in their hands. So they go to the market and buy goods. So their money enters the market and everybody gets its share and everybody profits because their goods are selling. Everybody produces more and again dumps into the market. More people have money in their hands. So that cycle continues. So due to economic development, the amount of money increases in the economy and income of the people increases. When income increases, people are able to spend more. That is, purchasing power increases and hence they start consuming and demanding more goods and services from the market. In short, that is what I explained, that the goods are selling more, producer ko profit hota hai, wo aur invest karta hai, aur produce karta hai, aur market mein dalta hai, और प्रॉफिट आता है. दैट प्रॉफिट ही शेयर्स विद द एम्प्लॉयज बाय इंक्रीजिंग द सैलरी. सो नाउ द एम्प्लॉयज आर आल्सो हैविंग मनी, दे आल्सो गो टू द मार्केट एंड बाय गुड्स एंड अगेन दैट साइकिल कंटिन्यूज. द डिमांड इंक्रीजेस, मोर प्रोडक्शन इज डन टू सप्लाई दैट डिमांड एंड पीपल गो एंड बाय बिकॉज दे हैव मनी इन देयर हैंड्स. बट सिंस द प्रोडक्शन कैन नॉट बी डन एज फास्ट एज द सडन राइज इन द income and demand, then occurs the shortage of goods and services, which then leads to price rise. Government has given lots of good opportunities where some laws are relaxed, some rules are relaxed, some of the policies have changed because of that. Now people can produce more, export more, keep more employees and make them work, pay them properly, more salary. So everybody is earning more. That means more and more money is in the hands of the people. So they go to the market and place demands, and thus more production is done. That means more money keeps on coming, more people go to the market and buy. But jitna demand hai utna supply nahi hota, to price rise hota. So good governance. The government is trying to do something good, but in return it gets a price rise. Next, increasing circulation of money, that is increasing money transaction in the market by increasing government expenditure. How does more money come into the market? Yes, government khud hi jyada expenditure karna shuru kar dete hain, right? Increasing circulation of money. Wow, how does circulation of money? It is that same way. I have more money in my pocket. I am going to go to the market and buy more goods. More goods, that means all of a sudden the demand has increased. So production has to increase because more demand is there, right? So increase in circulation of money, that is increasing money transaction in the country by increasing government expenditure. By increasing government expenditure, government undertakes planned expenditure and non-planned expenditure both. By undertaking such expenditures, government is increasing supply of money in the market. Railway track banana hai, kitne logo ko employment mil gaya. Dam banana hai, kitne logo ko employment mil gaya. Kitne logo ko employment opportunity khul gaya. There will be lots of trucks needed over there. There will be lots of hotels, restaurants needed for the executives to stay nearby, right? So all of a sudden there is a rise in the demand of the market. Lots of investment is needed, right? So people invest. That means more money is going to pump in the market because the government has increased planned and non-planned expenditure. When the supply of money increases, the income of people increases. This in turn increases the purchasing power and eventually leads to price rise. Government ne khud hi price rise karwaya. Kaise? By increasing their planned and non-planned expenditure. Both of these things were done for the welfare of the people. But at the end, what did we get? We got a price rise. So this is one of the first reasons that government itself is the reason behind the price rise, right? It is doing everything for the benefit of the people. Dam ban gaya, to dam mein se canal nikala hai, to canal ka construction karna padega. To do the construction of the canal, they have to give tenders, and people will offer tenders, and somebody will get the tender and start working over there. That means he is going to need hundreds of people to construct the canal. Digging work chahiye, cementing work chahiye, right? Lots and lots of work, right? So more people are getting employment. Earlier these people did not have employment and they did not have money in their hands. Now those people got employment and now they are having money in their hand. Where will they go? Home? No, first they are going to go to the market, right? मेरे बच्चों को अच्छा खाना खिलाता हूँ, स्वीट्स ले जाता हूँ, कपड़े ले जाता हूँ, डिमांड बढ़ गया. All of a sudden, because more people are having money in their hands. So this way government itself is responsible when it increases its planned and non-planned expenditure. Along with this, factors of production such as land, labor, machinery starts getting more work and hence more value. उसको ये उल्टी तरफ से देखो, right? कि मशीन्स को काम करने के लिए इलेक्ट्रिसिटी चाहिए. ज्यादा मशीन्स होंगे, ज्यादा काम होगा, ज्यादा इलेक्ट्रिसिटी चाहिए, राइट? सो योर डिमांड फॉर इलेक्ट्रिसिटी आल्सो गोज अप. ऑफ कोर्स एवरीबॉडी इज पेइंग फॉर द इलेक्ट्रिसिटी, राइट? सो अलोंग विद दैट, लैंड भी महंगा हो गया. ऑल ऑफ अ सडन डैम का कंस्ट्रक्शन के लिए साइट मिल गया, अप्रूव हो गया, सब. सो लैंड ओवर देयर इज गोइंग टू बी कॉस्टली. There will be roads going to that particular place. So, aju baju dhaba khul gaya, right? So, acquisition of land, lots and lots of money gets pumped into the market, right? So factors of production such as land, labor, machinery starts getting more work and hence more value. Now people have to pay more, right? So more money is flooding into the market because of these planned and non-planned expenditure. This also increases the flow of money, which then leads to price rise. Yes, unnecessarily bahut sare logo ke haath mein paisa aa gaya, right? So what are they going to do? Improve their standard of living. Yes, purana fridge nikal do, naya le aate hain. Purani car nikal do, nahi le aate hain. Purana ghar badal do, naya ghar lete hain. Because they have money in their hands. All of this happened because now more demand is there. So what will happen? Price will rise. Whatever services or whatever goods you are purchasing, whatever land you are, everything, everywhere, value is going to go high because demand is more. People have more money in their hands. C, A pad liya, B pad liya. Now this is C of the first reason. Decreasing rate of interest on debt. How? Decreasing rate of interest on debt. The bank reduces rate of interest on credit and increases its reserved cash. This increases the supply of money in the hands of people. How to understand this? See, suppose you are you're building a house. You need a loan of 20 lakh rupees. You need a loan of 20 lakh rupees. You're going to go to the bank to take a home loan, right? So now what happens? The bank is ready to give you loan in normal condition, right? So suppose I'm saying this three times because we are only dealing with examples. Yes, so suppose you take a loan at say 2% per month. You're taking a loan of 20 lakh rupees at 2% per month, right? Now this is the interest that the bank is charging to give you this much money. Suppose you have taken a loan for 10 years, right? At the end of 10 years, you have to pay 20 lakh rupees plus whatever the interest is upon this. Now, decreasing the rate of interest on debt, D-E-B-T, debt. Debt means apne jo loan liya ya jo udhari li hai. The bank reduces the rate of interest on credit and increases its reserved cash. So for 20 lakh rupees, you were ready to pay 2%. That was the demand of the bank. Now the bank has reduced its rate on credit. The credit it's giving you, right? So now the bank is ready to give you at 1.7%. That means you have to pay 0.3% less, and compared to the interest, believe me, it's quite a huge amount, right? That much you are saving. Earlier you had to give 2%, now you have to give just 1%. You are saving this much money. It's quite a huge amount of money. आपके पास इतना extra पैसा आ गया, क्या करोगे? So that increases the flow in the market because now people are having more money and increases its reserved cash. This increases the supply of money in the hands of the people. Now people have to pay less interest. That means they now have more money in hands. Earlier 2% was going, now only less is going. So they have more money in hand. So what are they going to do? They are going to go to the market and spend it. So when people have more money in the market, they increase their demands for commodities and so the price rises. Yes, turant hisab lag jata hai. Haan, is bar interest mein 2% less. So my EMI is going to come down by 2000 rupees. I will have 2000 rupees extra with me. Yes. Bazaar mein jao, udao. Now we come to the second reason for price rise. That's world famous one is population growth. India is the second largest populated country in the world, and we have a ratio of 2% per annum. 130 करोड़ लगा लो तो उसका 2% हर साल बढ़ जाता है. That's so. In India, population increases at an annual rate of, आपको अच्छा लगाने के लिए क्या रखा है, 1.9. Actually, that is 1.92. Right? So, 2% में सिर्फ 0.08 का डिफरेंस है. You can count it as 2% for better calculation, but when you are writing the answer, it should be 1.9. Please do not write 2%. In India, population increases at an annual rate of 1.9%. That means itne crore log badh jate population. Population badh gaya, demands of commodities and services also will go up, but supply is not that much. If the population remained constant, then demand will remain constant because population is not increasing. Supply will be able to compensate the demand. But the demand goes higher and higher every year because population goes on higher. Hamare paas utne hi land hai, hamare paas utna hi agricultural products hai, hamare paas utna hi industrial products hai. Demand ke hisab se supply nahi aata. So what happens is the price goes up. In 2011, India's population was 121 crores. The population grew quite speedily since 2001. 2001 se spike aaya, and rise in population increases, but we failed to fulfill it because according to the demand raised, the supply was not able to meet that demand. It was always lower than the demand. So what happened? This created an imbalance in demand and supply. Demand was high, supply was low. So what happens is imbalance ho gaya, right? So everybody cannot get that same thing. The people who pay more will get it. So the price is going to rise. Yes. So the example that I gave you earlier regarding sugar, right? 30 rupees, okay, people will manage it. Well, all of a sudden it becomes 50 rupees and 60 rupees and 70 rupees. Those people who can afford it, they are going to buy 1 kg. Those who are not able to buy will have to buy 200 grams because the price has increased. It's adjustable. So, jo 1 kg 30 rupees milta tha, wo 60 rupees mil gaya. Then that poor man is going to buy 500 grams also. Then also he is paying 30 rupees. Earlier to get 1 kg he used to pay 30 rupees. Now for that same money he is getting half of it because sugar price went up from 30 to 60. Because the demand is so high, people are ready to pay more. So those who are able to pay more, they will get it. Otherwise people will have to compromise. So this created an imbalance in the demand and supply, which led to the shortage or leading to the price rise. 3. Increase in export, that we have learned in chapter number 16. Liberalization, privatization and globalization. When we accepted these three policies, economic, when we did changes in our economic policies of 1991, we accepted these three things, and from there, earlier there was lots of restriction on export. You had to take a license from the government, and if the government gives you permission, then only you can export. But all these were removed with the help of liberalization and privatization. That means you can produce any amount, you can sell it in India and you can sell it outside India. Nobody is asking. So what happened? People started producing and exporting it. That created a shortage in India. Now the same things are manufactured in India, but they are not available in India because exports increased. So a very small quantity is available in India and the demand is quite high. The supply in India is less. So price has to rise because Now, who pays more will get it. So, the demand of Indian goods has increased in the foreign market. The government also encourages exports because we are getting rich foreign exchange. We are getting money in dollars. We are getting money in pound. We are getting money in yen. So, the government is interested in getting rich foreign exchange because we are exporting and getting money in foreign currency. So, our reserve of foreign currency increases. But what about the demand in the country? You are producing wheat and exporting it outside. So wheat available over here is less. So what will happen? What will happen is the demand becomes more in the country, but the same supply in the country becomes less. So producers are not able to meet internal as well as export demand. So by exporting goods and services, there arises a shortage of supply in the local market, and so price will rise. So because of that, because everything that is exported, now the producers are not able to balance it because they are more interested in selling outside and getting more money and foreign exchange. And the government is also not stopping them. So what happens is they produce in India, but they sell it outside India. What about the local market? There is still lots of demand in the local market, but the goods are sold outside and not in the country. So what happens is there is quite a high demand in the country, but the supply to the countrymen, it's quite less because everything is exported outside. So what happens is very small supply, huge demand, and so price is going to rise, right? So increase in export is yet another reason for price rise. Students, we'll stop over here for the day. Continue in the next lecture. Thank you.